In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Good evening. Buonasera. My name is Father Riccardo Ferrucci, and this is the first of a new series. So, straight from Vatican City, we present Vita da Carne. Now, about me. I was born in Parco Inverno near Roma. I was always good, but I talked too much and I was not very clever. So my father naturally wanted me to be a priest. I started as an altar boy, and I was sort of crazy about Father Kennedy, Americano. Ah, yes, I'm gay. Unfortunately, I was not molested. What am I, chopped liver? So, in retaliation, I put ink in the holy water and drank the wine. I think it was mischievous. Anyway, it was not very good. I was kicked out of school. They were Jesuits and very tough. Anyway, I easily got into the seminary. They take anyone these days. Anyone can become a priest. So afterwards, they sent me to the Marconi School of Broadcasting. And this is my first job. The only problem is I have to tell the truth, la verità, and I have no training for that. Our new Pope loves being interviewed, so that is really nice for me. Francesco is from Argentina, and he's very friendly and more alive than all the other popes, especially the German. He gives tango lessons on Saturday mornings. Of course, although he is economizing, the church is very poor after all these lawsuits. So the Holy Father is bringing back indulgences. The church will charge a dollar for a lie, $1,000 for murder, $25 for texting and driving, but only 5 cents for Master Comicidici Bation. That's a pretty cheap, but it mounts up. You to know there is no truth to this story. A tourist was approached outside the albergo near Vatican City. Would you like a blonde? No. Would you like a brunette? No. Would you like a redhead? No, no, no. Oh, I see. Would you like a boy? No, absolutely not. I'm here for the Pope. The next day, this bad man was waiting again outside the hotel. I couldn't get the Pope, but I have a very nice looking Cardinale. Well, it wasn't a cardinale at all. It was just a bishop. Next week, I am going to talk about afterlife, heaven and hell. So, tune in on Wednesday at 9. Buonasera, ciao, e Dio te benedico. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Good evening. I am Pat Naggiar, and you are watching Off the Record. Tonight we bring you this special report from an undisclosed location in Florida. Following his acceptance into the Priestly Protection Program, it is here that Father Ricardo Ferrucci now resides and pays penance to the Catholic Church. What started as a promising career at Vatican Television has instead plunged faster than Greece's stock market. So sit back and watch my exclusive interview with Father Ricardo. I know this is very difficult for you, Father, but thank you very much for giving us this exclusive interview.
I'm sorry we have to use this confessional box, Patrizia. May I call you Pat? But, you know, I'm in the Priestly Protection Program, so I have to be careful. By the way, hearing confessions is so boring. You know, just the same old sins. And it's so hot in here. We cannot charge, but since I'm so broke, maybe you would give me $10 to hear your confession after the interview?
No, thank you. My sources tell me that you have failed all of your papal polygraph tests. Do you care to comment on that?
Maybe it was because I was not telling the truth.
It's a pity that you didn't keep your program at Vatican Television longer. It's a shame you never had an interview with the Pope.
I see, yes, yes. His Holiness is a very clever man. You know, he's the cousin of Vita. I don't think that he'll agree to same-sex marriages this year, but soon. He's very forward-looking. Right now, he's studying world religions, and he likes the Hindu idea of people coming back as something else just to punish them, you know, as a worm or an ant or something. It's not fun to be a worm. He firmly believes, for instance, that nuns used to be mafiosi, so we don't have to be nice to them anymore. No.
If you would like to ask him a question, what would it be?
Is your dance card full?
I think the Pope's dance card is pretty full since he gives tango lessons every Saturday morning.
Shh! I hear the Holy Father. Yes, it's the Pontiff pontificating. Well, anyway, my sin was that I was poor and Protestants were out to get me. So I had this great idea of using Vatican Television Studio 803 to make porno films. So, okay, I committed a mortal sin. I earned thousands with my porn shows under the pseudonym of D. Frocker, streaming it live on vatiporn.com. After all, the Vatican has the largest collection of pornography in the world. Could I ask you a question, sister? If I am defrocked,
Does your network have an opening for me here in
Florida? I'm sorry, but we're cutting staff at the moment. Anyway, we're out of time, and I want to thank you very much, Father, and good luck.
Well, I'm gonna ask you another question. Where is God?
I'm not sure, but he certainly is not here. After all, this is secular television.
What do you mean? I am God, and I am everywhere. And why? Because I love you. Oh, God. Yes, I know. Well, good night, everybody. Buonasera, ci vediamo, ciao, arrivederci.
We leave you now with some lovely images of Father Ricardo strolling through Florida's cloistered, hallowed grounds. So good night from secular television, and until next week. All right, let's try another one. Since I'm looking a bit off camera, does it make any difference?
Yeah.
It does.
Yeah.